Hello students, welcome back to our channel. Today we will read lesson number 2 of our English literature book Communicate with Cambridge. Lesson number 2, Bukka Learns a Lesson, written by Dipanvita Roy. So we will read this chapter. You have to see how I am reading and you will check the pronunciation. Okay, so same ways you have to practice this, okay? Remember, you are all big animals. The older elephants warn the juniors. When lying down on the ground, you must watch out for snails. See that you don't crush them under your weight. It is the snail that tells you when flood water enters the forest. Check to see if there are baby squirrels in the hollows of trees when you shake the branches of a tree to pick the fruits. Then these animals will be the first ones to give you news of any danger. The squirrel will bring you news of an approaching forest fire. Here few word meanings are given. So I'm not explaining this chapter because this video is about reading of this chapter. So you have to see how we have to read this chapter, right? The older elephants do not only teach the young elephants how to live in harmony with others, but also teach them how to live in harmony among their own kind. When you get news of good food, the elders tell the juniors, "You must not eat alone. You must send a message to others." And if any member of the herd faces danger, everyone must rush to help. You should always remember, however big you are, you might face danger if you are alone. The young elephants listen to their elders with rapt attention. Only Bukka does not like to listen to all this. Bukka knows that one day he will become the leader of the herd. He will become huge and have those big tusks. Everyone in the jungle will be afraid of him. So Bukka doesn't bother to make friends with those small creatures at all. "Am I a fool that I will share any good food that I find?" thinks Bukka. "In fact, I should be eating all that good food, shouldn't I? I have to grow up quickly. After all, I have to become the leader one day." So Bukka breaks off flowers and also branches with nests. He crushes snails underfoot. He squirts water into rabbit holes with his trunk. All the animals are tired of his mischief. One day they complain to the leader of the elephant herd, "Please do something." They tell the leader, "Bukka is becoming very naughty." The leader hears them out and realizes that naughty Bukka needs to be taught a lesson. That night, like always, Bukka goes to sleep next to his mother's warm side. But in the morning, he wakes up surprised. He finds himself alone on the banks of the small pool. There is simply no one. Bukka jumps up and searches near the pool. No, there is no sign of the elephant herd. He lifts his trunk to catch the smells floating in the breeze. No luck there. Bukka feels frightened. He starts crying. What will happen now? Where will he find his parents in such a huge and dense forest? Poor Bukka turns to the birds, animals, and insects in the forest for help. But they all turn away. The squirrel says, "Have you forgotten? how you shook the branches and made us fall? The rabbit mother says, don't you remember how you poured water down our hole? We nearly died. Now see how it feels. Serves you right. The butterflies too refuse to help him. Bukka starts crying, and then he falls asleep, crying beside the pool. Next day, when he wakes up, he finds himself sleeping right in the middle of his herd, next to his mother's warm belly. Was that a dream? Thinks Bukka to himself. After that day, no one complains about Bukka ever again. So, students, this way you have to do reading practice of this chapter. If you want explanation video of this chapter, you can just comment below and then I'll share explanation video of this chapter as well. If you like this video, please press like button, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Goodbye, take care, keep reading, and get success in your life.